To our continuing coverage of the NBA Finals on 2K Sports, we're here for pivotal Game 4 with the Big Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, I'm Ernie Johnson, and let's get started. The action coming to you from Portland, where the Trailblazers will be hosting the series tonight up against the Philadelphia 76ers. Taking a look at the 76ers, they won Game 3 going away and are looking to make another statement tonight. Definitely a bounce in their step. A sweep, a very real possibility here with this team up 3-0 in the series. You've been in this situation in the finals, Shaq. How does the momentum in this series impact Game 4?
You know, when you're up 3-0, Ernie, you smell blood in that water.
Kind of like a shark.
It's like a shark. The whole team can just taste how close they are to the title. They're already sensing the title this year, but can't get cute. You got to do what you've been doing the whole time.
If you think about sweep, it's not going to happen. You have to think about one game at a time. This is the moment, and you just have to realize that you're closer to your goal. Don't think about sweeps and brooms and all the fans throwing things up in the air. You think about the moment, and you'll be okay.
And both of you have been there winning NBA titles. And with that, it's just about time for the tip. We'll see you next time.
Of a clean sweep, a 3-0 start to this year's NBA Finals. We'll see if they can pull it off. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And joining us in a bit later from the sidelines, Doris Burke. It's Philadelphia and the Portland Trailblazers.
Ready to go?
Look at the Trailblazers. They're trailing 3-0. They're hoping for a miracle. They're going to lay it all on the line tonight as they look for their first win of this series.
And obviously, guys, they've got an uphill battle. I mean, nobody has ever come back from a 3-0 deficit. But you just try to win one game, and you never know what happens. Injury-wise, momentum-wise, a crazy break here or there. So just win this one and give yourself a chance.
Yeah, I agree with you. You've got to play it through. And certainly these fans, how about them? They have not given up. They're still 100% behind this team. And, you know, 3-0 comebacks have happened in other sports. Hockey and baseball have seen it happen. Maybe it's time for it to happen in basketball.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So on the floor for Philadelphia, Freak, he's in at the point. Also Elliott out there, and it's Okafor in at the five. And Portland has possession. Philadelphia able to drain the three. And Batum kicks to McCollum. Right side sets the pick for McCollum. Lillard, right side. Batum wide open. He fires. Good. Great play by Lillard to set it up. Batum's got his first points of the game. Now here's Freak, covered by Lillard. Lillard with the rebound. The Trailblazers have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Batum attacking, and there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two. And there's the foul against Philadelphia. And he's got his first free throw of the game. The first one falls. And both free throws good for Nicholas Batum.
That's a familiar sight. He hardly ever wastes his chances at the line. Cashes in regular.
Let's send it out to Doris Burke, who caught up with head coach Terry Stotts. DB.
We talked about the uphill battle this team was facing, and he said, I am trying to use the historical perspective of our situation in a different light. We could get down on ourselves, but now we have a chance to make history if we were to come back in these finals. That's one way to look at it, guys.
Thanks, Doris. Freak. And that one is stuffed right through.
And that is a major league flush right there, my friends.
And in a tight contest like this, Greg, that might be just what they need to get the tide rolling in their direction.
You're exactly right. I mean, so often when a team gets that kind of explosive play out of its backcourt, that can really rally and galvanize the whole squad.
Philadelphia's gone 2-of-2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
Both good from the line that time. For Portland, they've gone 3-of-5 shooting the ball so far. Cullen passes to Whiteside. Lillard dishes to Davis. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Pass to Freak. 16 feet away, and good on the basket. Book it. Freak's got his third bucket of the night.
And really smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Showed nice basketball IQ. I agree, Greg. I mean, if he finds his spot on the perimeter and doesn't force it, I think his outside shot will be hard to block no matter who's defending.
The 76ers lead. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in, passes it to Okafor. Brady defended by Batum. Six to shoot. And it's Portland with the rebound. They want to put some distance between them and the loss on Monday.
Guys, it was like there was a lid on the basket in that game. No matter how many plays you make at the defensive end, hard to overcome such a lack of production offensively.
Well, you know, the high-quality shots were few and far between for them, guys. And they have nobody to blame but themselves for that. You've got to do a better job of working harder to put up points.
The Trailblazers have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Davis with a screen on Okafor. This one for three, and Nicholas Batum the bucket on the assist by McCollum. And that's now 7 points for Batum. 76ers trailing. Freak with it. He's got seven. Nice 4-for-7 from the floor with that shot.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
For Portland, they've gone 5-of-8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Lillard on top. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
The inside just a bit too congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with River.
Took him no time at all on that one. 11 points for Freak.
How about that move? Is this guy special or what? Just love watching him operate inside.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, guys. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team. He said their plan was run their offense through Freak. Coach wants to get him involved early so he can establish a strong presence at that end of the floor and provide them with a well-balanced offensive attack. Guys, we'll just have to watch how it plays out here in the first half. Kevin, back to you.
And thank you, Doris.
And that's a nice possession. Did a good job to get that open shot.
With some arc, and he lays it up and in.
That is an elegant move to drop in the floater there, guys.
Trailblazers trail by three. Dishes it to Simmons. 50 seconds left in the first quarter. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Not much defense to speak of yet here, guys.
Nope. It's been all offense, fellas, all the time here early.
Right wing. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Feeds to Embiid. There's Freak. And not sure what he was thinking there. Here's McCollum. He dishes it to Simmons. All right, then. Let's get up. And now a chance to hear from point guard Damian Lillard as he explains his stoic demeanor on the floor. I would say, Clark, we probably shouldn't expect to see Lillard starring in any reality shows about his personal life.
I think that would be accurate. I mean, Lillard is a young man who is all about taking care of his business and doing what he needs to be doing. I mean,
it's a completely new group here for Philadelphia. Portland's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. So on the floor for Philadelphia, Freak, he's in at point guard. Bismack Biyombo is out there with Okafor. And it's Cage in at the three. Okafor with the steal. Kate defended by Batum. There's the double team from Whiteside. Now here's Freak. He's tightly guarded. The 76ers with another mix. Portland's gone 2 of 4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. Out left of the wing. Near the three-point line, it's McCollum. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard. Lillard's got 3 assists tonight. Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Now here's Freak, covered by Lillard. And Whiteside sends it back. Here's Batum. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
That's a terrific sequence at both ends of the floor. They block the shot and recover it for the fast break finish. Talk about great numbers from Batum. He's got 10 points, and he's chalked up 1 3-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times, he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions there.
Lillard with it, out-defended by Freak, and Batum kicks to Whiteside. Outside for Batum. Down low. Here's McCollum. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up. And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for Portland.
Boy, the three-point shot has really been dropping for him early on.
Also, guys, the passing has been terrific in the first half. They'll be happy with all those assists.
The 76ers trail by 5. Here's Freak. And the shot falls short this time.
You know, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far.
Davis sets a screen. Back to Lillard. Hits through for a second basket. He's now 2 for 6.
And they continue to add to their lead. They might be ready to pull away.
No surprise from my end. I mean, they've been really good, and they're looking even better at this moment.
Kicks it to Biyombo. Here's Grady. Sweet little floater.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
There's 45 seconds left in the second quarter.
I like the move to go 2 for 1 here.
So do I, Greg. I mean, I agree with you. They need to get a quick look and then try to get another possession after that.
Lillard, no good from 11 feet.
If he can improve on what's been a shaky day for him thus far, they could stretch this lead out.
We've got 22 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Now here's Freak. Tight defense on him. Good work defensively by Whiteside.
The tough shots aren't going down for him right now, but neither are the easy ones. I mean, he's got to find the rhythm somehow.
Cage.
Got it! Got it! What a shot!
Welcome back to game 4 as we get ready to start things up again.
You look at the game so far for Freak. He has 11 points, and he's chalked up 1 3-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times, he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
76ers trail. Lillard at the point with C.J. McCollum playing the two. Davis is out there with Batum, and it's Whiteside in at the pivot spot manning the middle. So that's who Terry Stotts starts the second half with. Portland's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Lillard attacking, and he slams that one down.
And that is a major league flush right there, my friends.
And in a tight contest like this, Greg, that might be just what they need to get the tide rolling in their direction.
You're exactly right. I mean, so often when a team gets that kind of explosive play out of its backcourt, that can really rally and galvanize the whole squad.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Trailblazers was simply terrific. He finished with 22 points, and he also added a few assists as he set up his teammates as well. You can credit his performance as a big part of their Game 3 win. Let's see what happens in Game 4, guys.
All right, thanks, Doris. He's got a lot of positives to take away from that game.
Yeah, he really does. It was one of his better performances, and that's saying something because we've seen this guy have a lot of good ones.
And you'd have to imagine that he'll be out to build on it, to go one better here tonight.
Trailblazers leading by three. Whiteside sets the pick for McCollum. Here's Davis, and he throws it down hard with one hand.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path to the bucket. Mm,
that is how it is done.
Excellent team play there on the pick.
We need to be more physical on the offensive end. Let's crash the glass, but be smart. We need to limit their easy baskets, so get back on D.
These players can flat out shoot the rock. The 2K leaderboard shows us the top three-point shooters.
Well, you know, the three-point shot, Kevin, can be a game-changing play. I mean, I've seen games become blowouts, and blowouts become close thanks to the three-point shot. It's a huge asset, and these guys capitalize on it big time.
Now here's Freak, covered by Lillard. And now Lillard running the floor all by himself.
Just a good, solid, aggressive finish there on the break.
Not going to get much easier than that, Greg. Simple.
Here's Marjanovic. Goodbye, Lillard. Here's Freak. And no good. The dry spell continuing for him.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Lillard, the pass to Batum. Whiteside a screen. McCollum dishes to Whiteside. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Take a look at what Hassan Whiteside's done. He's got 8 points, and he's tacked on a couple of blocks today, too.
And they've been important to the team. Even if it's only a couple, it's helped them establish a defensive presence inside.
So for the Trailblazers, Nene, he's checked in for Davis. And Barea subbed in for Lillard. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. There's the dish to Freak. 14 feet away. Connects. The jumper drops. Freak's got 17.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Barea kicks to McCollum. There's the triple. But they get it back. The feed now to Barea. Out to the right wing. McCollum passes to Whiteside. And the shot is good. Whiteside's got four this quarter.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
It really has, Clark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of dealing with their passing.
Goes up to the stripe. Bounces high off the rim and drops. 19 points for Freak. A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. Barea dishes to Nene. He kicks it to Batum to the right side. Whiteside sets the pick for McCollum. He feeds it to Barea. Nene left side. Down to five on the shot clock.
Nobody even close to him, and he can't believe he doesn't knock it down.
Pass to Freak. Puts up a three. Barea pulls it in. Barea's got three rebounds now in this one.
One made three for him for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
Trailblazers leading by seven. Whiteside kicks to McCullough. 13 feet away. And he gets it to go. The Nays got his first 2 points of the night. The 76ers have gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Now the pass to Freak from deep. The 76ers with another miss. Elliott passes to Embiid, and he banks in the layup. Embiid's got his second bucket of the game to go.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot of those opportunities.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Let's spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Was able to listen in on what Mike Budenholzer had to say to his team. He said their plan was run their offense through Freak. Coach is looking for him to take on a lot of responsibility when they've got the ball, to be a leader at the offensive end. There's still plenty of basketball left to play, and as we watch how these adjustments play out, Kev, it'll be interesting.
Thanks, Doris. .114 left to play in the third. Plumlee with the screen. Portland again missing.
And with room like that off the pick, you have got to knock that one down.
Well, you know, they did everything right, Greg. They executed. All you want is a good look at the basket. Sometimes the shots just don't fall.
And here's McCullough. 5 points in the game. Shot from free throw range. And that one's good. McCollum's got the lead up to 9 now for Portland.
It's got to be nice for them to know that game in and game out, his offense is going to be there for him.
Here's Freak. Off the left rim and out.
Can't get anything to drop. I mean, the way he's going, it's probably not something he should try and shoot his way out of it.
Well, they say you should shoot your way out of it, but his teammates probably have other thoughts in mind. The last thing they want to see him doing is continuing to cast that jumper up.
Ed Davis is checked in for Portland. Lillard comes in for J.J. Barea. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Pass to Freak. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It goes on Ed Davis.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
They'll probably let the clock wind down here.
Right on. I mean, no need to give the ball back before the end of the quarter in this situation.
They set the screen. A wide open look for Plumlee.
All right, I want everyone to give it up for your Blazers.
Hello and thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play should begin momentarily. Trailblazers leading by 7. Taking a look at the 76ers. Freak in at shooting guard. He's out there with Jones. And it's Okafor in at the center filling out the middle. Here's Simmons. 5 on the clock. Passes it to McCollum. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Okafor's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Freak dishes to Jones. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Freak with it. Now guarded by Plumlee. And it's Freak missing.
Solid job by them on the glass here tonight. +8 in rebound.
You know what? That rebound has always been a critical element of the game. And that's why they are now understanding how to win.
The 76ers trail by 7. Dishes it to Jones. Feeds it to Freak. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for Portland. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. Shoots from the elbow. Here's Marjanovic, and down it goes, jamming that one home.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spark.
Which is a spark they desperately need, Kevin. They've got to ramp up the intensity.
Simmons, that's good. Jonathan! And the Trailblazers lead by seven.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there, and a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. And he made it look easy that time.
Lillard misses. The 76ers trail by five. Jones drives in. Here's Marjanovic. On the wing, Jones. Defended by Batum. And it's Okafor. That time on the assist by Jones.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
And Lillard kicks to Davis. Can't get it to go.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
Guy is a potent offense right now.
Yeah, Kevin, really the offense is flowing quite nicely right now.
You know what, guys, and they're playing with a certain amount of assuredness in their game. That type of confidence is what leads teams to having success.
And the basket by Lillard.
A tough first half, but it's been a different story here since the break.
Can't guard us on the perimeter.
Both teams will make substitutions.
Spacing.
Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. Fires high post. That one's in there, and the Portland lead is cut down now to just three on the bucket from Freak.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question, I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth. I mean, full throttle ahead.
Fires, high post. No what? And it's Portland the other way. Their biggest lead of the game was nine. Lillard outside. And some room here for Batum. It's hauled in by the 76ers.
Move it. Move it.
Here's Freak. That's good. Freak's got 16 here in the second half.
Big time basket there on the inside. I mean, he had to get that one up and over the big guy.
Way up and over the big guy. And what a time in the ball game to make it happen.
Back to Lillard. That will fall for his seventh bucket. 7 for 15 in this game.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
Here's Marjanovic, guarded by Barea. Freak.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And let's take a moment, guys, to get your taste on the scoring so far for the Trailblazers.
So far, they've turned in a fantastic performance from the three-point line. It's been a weapon all game.
And also, their mid-range game has been impressive. A tough shot to rely upon, but they really had it going tonight.
The Trailblazers making a switch here. McCollum's checked in.
We got to be more physical on defense. They are getting to the middle of the floor way too easy. Get into them on the perimeter. Posts. Rotate over and make your presence felt. Quit being so soft.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Terry Stotts as he addressed his team. He gave his guys the green light to keep firing from downtown, telling them, listen, I like the work you're doing out there. Keep finding those gaps on the perimeter. They're giving us open shots.
Thank you, Doris. Davis sets a screen. Lillard, the pass to McCollum. And Embiid pulls it down.
Some of the shots he's taken have been real head scratches. I mean, come on, he's out there playing like it's a game of horse at the park. He has really punished these defenders today. No matter who's been on him, he's been giving them medicine.
That's good. Lillard's got six in the quarter.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making it up for lost time.
Here's Freak. Here's Embiid, and it's thrown down hard with both hands. Boy, right down to the wire here, Clark. Still anyone's ball game.
Both teams really invested now. I mean, this is the type of game you love to win, and you'd hate to lose. Oof.
Yeah, and after all the energy both sides have expended, both teams still hungry for the win.
And a wide-open look for Freak. Hands the three.
He's finding all kinds of ways to get it done. What a quarter he's having.
Guys, some great passing from him.
Yeah, it makes it tough for the defense to chase that ball around when it moves that crisply all over the court.
Yeah, everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assists pile up because the rhythm is on display offensively.
McCollum gets to Davis, got a piece of it, and now they decide to foul intentionally. First free throw is good, and that puts them up by five. Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. Now McCollum. Davis sets a screen. Looking to get back on track here. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul.
He had to foul, and on that occasion, to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the strike, and they're right there within range. You know, late-game free throws are a lot different than early-game free throws in terms of making.
And that's the knockout blow right there, guys. Those free throws should put this one away.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Whiteside kicks to Davis. On the wing, Batum. And they've done it, the new NBA champions. What a moment it is right now to see the team who played so well together enjoying, Clark, this NBA championship moment.
Well, Kevin, it's awesome to be here to witness what happened tonight.
And seeing this team come together over the course of the season and on into the playoffs, what a joy. I mean, there is no better champion the league could have asked for.
And a pleasure here at 2K Sports to be with you all season long. Good night, everyone.